Welcome to Honey and Brown.
Welcome. What do we do here?
We do anime and music.
Today?
And today is Music Corner, or what we call MJ Corner.
Basically a part of our channel where I've already heard the song and I'm introducing it to my wife. Typically these are basically songs by artists or an artist that has been very influential on my life, and I finally get to play it all for my wife. We've been going down a MJ journey because there's so many iconic moments that you haven't seen. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this is basically me showing her and showcasing who Michael was, because Michael is and will always be my favorite of all time when it comes to like music in general. So,
but first we want to thank everyone, like, yeah, you know, who still continues to subscribe to us. We really appreciate you guys even after our break. Yeah. Like, thank you so much for getting us that 1,000 subscribers.
Yeah, it's insane. But thank you guys so much. So typically, before we start, what song are we doing today?
Billie Jean, Motown 25?
Motown? Yeah, you almost got it. So it's Michael Jackson, Billie Jean, the Motown 25. This is one of the most iconic performances done by Michael Jackson. Everybody knows this performance if you are a Michael fan. Even if you're not, you know, this was Michael at his peak. This is like this performance and this time he like just shot up and projected and became a huge megastar after this. But so yeah, we'll watch the video, and then afterwards we usually have a very in-depth conversation about what we watch. So if you're into that, stay tuned. But let's get on to it. This is Michael Jackson, Billie Jean, the Motown 25 live performance.
Mm-hmm.
You ready for this?
Kind of nervous.
All right, hit it. Oh, look at that goddamn icon, man.
I know.
Look at the crowd. Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
He's going crazy.
His socks. They match his shirt.
Oh yeah.
Oh, look at him. Look at him, man. this, man. Get ready. Oh my god. Oh my god.
God,
I freaking conic. All right, so much to say about that. But the biggest takeaway is that when I was like reading up on it, this was the first time Michael ever did the moonwalk on stage, like in front of people, like the first time. Can you imagine being there and seeing like just this weird move of him moving backwards, and you're like, and at first you're like, what, like how did he do that? I mean, we have seen it so much now, like the moonwalk is synonymous with Michael Jackson. Mm-hmm. But my god, like to see that for the very first time in history, like that is something that you can put into a time capsule and, you know, show people thousands or millions of years later. And that, like, it's an iconic moment in the music and in the entertainment as a whole. Beautiful.
Like, I don't blame people for like not being able to understand Michael, because like he is just like what he can just create. He is such a creator. Like, he is a prodigy. I know we've been saying this so many times, but when I just see him, like, you know, perform, like, oh my god, like he is just on a different level. Like, you see him give everything to you, and then the things that he can create while he's on stage. I've never, like, I've seen people, like, you know, have concerts, but they always have, like, you know, it seems like they always need that backup dancers.
Yeah.
But for Michael, it's just like a supporting to him, but he doesn't need it. Like, you can see it here that he does not need it. He is all you need on stage for you to be entertained, because like you can see like his blood sweat, it's just there.
Yeah.
Like, oh my god, like the way he danced, he's so light like a feather. Like, he
is the spotlight. Like,
yeah,
you don't need a spotlight on him because his star just like shines through. But
mm-hmm.
You know, there's so much about that performance that's very iconic and very important to who Michael was after that, because I didn't grow up in the 80s with Michael mania, right? I grew up, you know, I was born in the 80s, but I was raised in the 90s. So
mm-hmm.
Michael was always a huge star. But at this time, Michael was just, I mean, he had released Off the Wall, his very first like solo, his solo release working with Quincy Jones. It's, you know, but, you know, he was a star, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, he's been a star since he was a kid, but, you know, when he in the 80s, man, Michael blew up. But this performance off of the Thriller album, which is the greatest selling album of all time,
mm-hmm.
but this performance with Motown, and Motown being very important to the black community as a whole, because Motown Records, they showcase a lot of black or like African American artists, right? Mm-hmm. You know, they were responsible for like people like the Supremes and like a few other people. I mean, I'm not going to pretend like I know them all, but you know, reading up on what Motown was, very important, very influential to the Black community. And you know, Motown gave a spotlight to all of these Black artists to get them on the radio, to get them on TV, to get them, you know, to like the masses. And what's odd is that Michael Jackson actually had to be convinced to perform at Motown, not because like he didn't want to do Motown. From what I read, it was more that Michael, you know, we all know about Michael's childhood and all that stuff, right? And from what I read, it was more the fact that like Michael just didn't want to be on TV. Like he had a very negative connotation on TV because like his whole life has been on film or has been chased down by like, you know, paparazzi. Yeah. So I was reading up and like, here's a little quote that Michael said in his autobiography, Moonwalk. He tells about him having some apprehension about performing, right? He said like, I said no to the idea at first. I thought about how much Berry Gordy had done for me and the group, but I told my managers and Motown that I didn't want to go on TV. My whole attitude towards TV is fairly negative. And, you know, it goes on to say, like, after speaking to Berry Gordy, who visited Michael at a studio session to discuss it, Michael decided he would appear and perform with his brothers, including Jermaine. The only stipulation that he would get his own solo spot and do Billie Jean. It would be the only non-Motown song of the show. So as you can see, like, can you imagine, like, he didn't like want to do it because he, you know, he didn't want to be on TV and he, you know. And if we never saw that performance, I mean, Michael would have been a star regardless of that performance, but that showcase to the world what he is like, that he is not just a star, a superstar. He is at the time a legend and an icon in the making, you know. And to see the Moonwalker the first time, like, a lot of people didn't see like these type of dances at the time.
Yeah,
very different dance to what they're accustomed to. And I would honestly say that, you know, I think people were more accustomed to of a more conservative type of performance, but Michael just brought this new type of swagger, this whole new style to the world. Like, this changed the world. Like, this performance literally changed the world, changed how people viewed Michael and, you know, like this type of dance and this type of kind of like the artistry, right?
Yeah.
So I don't know, I'm blown away when I first watched that in the 90s. I mean, as a kid, I was like, holy crap. And I think that was the first time I ever saw the Moonwalk in general as well, was during that performance. Yeah. You know, when I saw that as a kid, I was like blown away. I was like, well, what the hell is that? Like, what is that move? Like, it's like seeing something new for the first time, you know?
Yeah. And so, like, you don't understand what this is, yeah, like, but it's amazing. You know that it's amazing.
Yeah. And we watch a performance and we know that, like, it's very iconic. But, you know, Michael, he actually, I mean, he's a perfectionist, right? Mm-hmm. But he actually did not like the performance. He actually said there was a lot of mistakes and a lot that he wished he would have perfected. So I found a clip online about him talking about it. It's about a minute long, so we'll just play it here.
Is that as good as it gets as a performer?
Gee, if I say no, I'll sound arrogant. I don't think I'm ever pleased with my performances. Never. And after that performance, I wasn't happy either. I wanted to do the five spins, then go on the toes and freeze there and just hold it and stay there, you know, and I didn't. But I was angry about that, actually. Real disappointed. And I didn't realize I really did well until the next day when Fred Astaire called my house in Encino, raving. He said, I can't believe it. You're an incredible mover. And I was, oh my God, I think maybe I did well.
Yeah, you like see how much of a perfectionist this guy was. He wasn't even happy with that performance. And like only he would see the flaws in his own perfection, you know? And it's kind of weird too, because like he said, like after like he did the Moonwalk, he wanted to like spin five times and land on his toes for like, you know, who knows how long, and he couldn't.
And freeze.
And freeze, and he didn't. And like to him, it bothered him. And it wasn't until like, you know, one of his role models, Fred Astaire said, like, wow, you are incredible. And he's like, am I incredible? Like, I don't know. I find that so endearing that, like, he's that much of a perfectionist and that he actually takes, you know, his, you know, songs and his performance, like, he takes it professionally. Like, he takes it very serious because that's a representation of who he is, you know? So
I just really love it whenever I see Michael speaks. Like, I love all his interviews. Like, the way he speaks is just so, like, he's so, like, genuine. Like, you can feel it through, like, the interviews that's really
that's
who
him.
He is. Yeah. And that's how he feels. And, like, for people, like, who I feel like Michael is a type A personality because I have that personality too, that, you know, it's like I can see very clearly what are my mistakes, but for other people it's like, oh, it's perfect, it's good enough. No, but like for him to be able to see like things that he, you know, he didn't like, mm-hmm. I love it. It's so human of him. Like, yeah. It's so real of him to say all those things to, like, you know, to kind of like criticize himself in that way. Like, I don't know. I love it. It just makes him like more relatable.
It's incredible to see or to hear a song, but then see it performed live by Michael. It just brings a whole new type of energy to it. So again, I love it. And, you know, finally you are starting to see a lot of Michael. Cause like, since we started the journey, you had no clue about Michael in general. And now you're starting to see like not only his songs and like, not just his iconic songs, but his whole plethora of songs that he has and how much talent he has. But now you're starting to see like moments in history where an icon was born. And like, if we could pinpoint when Michael became an icon, I mean, he was a star since he was a kid, but this performance, you know, and this performance you can pinpoint, this is when Michael became not just a star, not just a superstar, but he became like bigger than life. Like, he became Michael Jackson, you know, he became the king of pop, the king of music, the king of everything, you know. And it's very important that it was done at Motown, which is like a representation of, you know, like presenting Black artists to the world, you know, and for, you know, for everyone to always remember Motown, they'll always remember Michael Jackson's Billie Jean performance. And yes, he did perform with his brothers, and that was also very iconic and very, you know, in like it, like, very good. But this one right here, man, like the Billie Jean performance, it's still being replicated to this day. Like, you'll see a lot of artists, like a lot of like dancers, like Chris Brown, Justin Bieber, Usher, a lot of people, they go back to this performance as the performance that, you know, changed their lives and that made them want to perform, you know. Yeah. This was the Billie Jean performance at the Motown, was the biggest performance of all time. So very insane. But yeah, anyways, obviously we loved it.
Yes.
Yeah. Anything else you want to add to it?
No.
All right. anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for being patient and sticking around with us.
Yes. Like, we really appreciate you guys staying with us. Yeah. We truly do. Like, when we, you know, when we read your messages again, like, I think when my husband like made a post regarding like why we had to take a leave, you know, I was so touched and really wanted to get back on it right away. Yeah. It's because like, it's just so heartwarming that you guys are still there. We really are a community, and that is genuinely what we wanted for this YouTube channel, for us to be like, you know, a really like good community that everyone can just be here to talk, you know, everyone can like comment and, you know, share their thoughts, and like all of us would just, you know, comment to each other, talk to each other, because you know, that's, we need like more kindness in this world.
Yeah, but it's all thanks to you guys, so thank you guys so much again. And well, as I said, we'll try to keep somewhat of a schedule.
We'll probably do it like more of a weekly to kind of let you know what are the things that we have for this week.
Yeah,
but we can't do anything more than that because like, I think we tried doing that we tried to really push ourselves, but we burnt out very quickly,
and we never want to like fake anything on this show. Yeah. Like, I don't want to just come on here, react, and then bounce, right? Like, every video, especially when it comes to Michael Jackson, it needs to be a moment, it needs to be appreciated, it needs to have our full attention, our love, and our energy. So thank you guys so much for understanding. And yeah, we will see you in the next video.
See you.